Hello, Taurus. This is going to be your December 2023 Zodiac reading. If it's meant for you, it's meant for you. This reading is intended for all Taurus, Sun, Moon, Rising, and Venus signs, as well as a possible Taurus cross-watcher. So, you know, if this is for a Taurus in your life, see if it resonates. Now, we're going to take a look at the energies for this month. We have a few things to note astrologically, and that is, of course, that we have a new moon in Sagittarius coming up, I believe, on December 12th. That is the 12-12 portal. I've been feeling for a while that that date is going to be quite significant for people. Now, on top of that, we have Mercury retrograde. I say that with a bit of a nervous laugh or giggle because the very next day after the new moon, I believe it's on the 13th, Mercury will officially station, you know, retrograde. And yeah, I mean, nothing to fear, but I would just say be mindful of what you think, feel, do, and say, because it can manifest in ways you didn't anticipate, okay? Now, Venus is also moving into Scorpio, which means your relationships may feel even more intense and attached. And yeah, I mean, the holidays are coming up, so always a busy time. Let's see what's at the center of your energy right now. Root girl, the disowned self. Interesting. Just generally looking at that card, you have to let go of an old story about yourself, of who you used to be. Okay? I've been saying this in a few readings lately. That old narrative is simply that. It's old. It's old news. Okay? That's not who you are. And when you start changing the narrative, things change in your life. Now, with this, we have the Six of Wands. This is about victory. You want victory. I know that. And it's there. It's right at your fingertips. And the Page of Pentacles says there's an offer coming your way. This is also possibly studying or learning something new. And the Ace of Cups is a brand new emotional beginning. Taurus, it's time to fill your own cup. Oftentimes you're giving to everybody else but yourself. And this is your time. Okay? Now, with that, we have the Five of Pentacles. You're tired of feeling left out in the cold. And this is the thing, you know, I think when you were younger, you were, in a way, growing up quicker than you needed to, yet a bit of a late bloomer. That's very typical of Taurus, because oftentimes you're placating to family, you're having responsibilities put on you, and you feel guilty to say no. It's very hard for a Taurus to say no, because they want to provide and they want to give. But at the same time, that's what puts you last on the list. And then you feel left out in the cold, or you're upset that people don't reciprocate the same way. And you need to let that old self go, that old story, like I said. Because look, there's the Tower moment. You know, Taurus has gone through a lot. You know, the last year, especially with the North Node shifting, we're now in Aries and Libra, but it was in, you know, Scorpio and Taurus. I would just say that you've had a tough time and now you're in the process of rebuilding yourself. There is good luck coming. There are wonderful things on the horizon. But again, in order to have that new, you have to release the old. Otherwise, it's like a stuck feeling. And look, Six of Swords, isn't that what you want, is peace, right? You want to move to calmer waters. You want to feel calm and happy. And if that's the case, I mean, Three of Wands says don't sit on the sidelines anymore. You know, this is not about chasing a relationship. This is about personal growth and evolution for yourself. You know, stop saying, I'll do this tomorrow, next week, next month, next year. It's time to make some moves, right? And there's the King of Pentacles. Well, that's Taurus energy right there. King of Pentacles, slow, slow energy. Taurus doesn't do anything quickly. But at the same time, you know, there is abundance here and you will harvest. There's the grapes. You just have to believe in yourself and keep onwards and upwards. Now, I just want to make a point. That Root Girl card, 46, that's a number 10, right? 10 is an ending. 1 plus 0 is a 1. That's a beginning. And something is brewing. There's the Mortar and Pestle. I've been feeling this for a while for a lot of you. You know, the Butterfly, Metamorphosis, you're going through a major change. You're going to have that victory, but it requires you being open. And I mean authentically open, right? Not perceived openness, as I call it. Now, that Page of Pentacles, that offer, yeah, there's a light bulb here. There's an aha moment. There's clarity. Something is going to come to light for you. And the Grasshopper says you're going to trust, take a leap of faith. You're not going to worry anymore. That Ace of Cups is a brand new beginning emotionally. That Five of Pentacles feeling left out in the cold, that could be about love. Maybe you overgave to somebody and they didn't reciprocate, or they just couldn't give. Now you have a decision to make, because you know the Lovers is also a decision in love. And that Tower card, well, now you've got to like implement a strategy. And Taurus loves to plan, by the way. I know that. You know, it's time to implement a strategy. Look, here's the thing. The Six of Swords is about peace, right? And the Wolverine is about being fierce. Okay, you've got to be fierce and you got to push yourself forward, be determined. At the same time, there's a bit of a power struggle. Should I? Shouldn't I? Can I have this? I don't know. Of course you can. But you have to believe in yourself. You got to go towards your peace. And that Three of Wands we talked about, it's developing. Yeah, you're in the process of making some moves. Nobody says you have to change the world in a day, but you got to take some steps. You got to let it develop. And look, 11-11, brand new beginnings, the Twin Flames card. Now, this doesn't have to mean a confirmation or denial of Twin Flames. It's just the idea that there's a catalyst for change here. You need a balance of your masculine and feminine energies. And 11-11 signals brand new beginnings. Are you in the old? Are you in the new? Right? So let's see what you need to surrender or surrender to. And we have here, surrender to the wisdom of your body. Listen to your body's messages about a person or situation. If you feel physically drained or uncomfortable, be cautious. If you're energized and happy, move forward. Okay. Surrender to your full power. Your life is calling for you to step into your full power rather than playing it small. Exactly. It's your turn. It's your turn. So I really hope this resonates with you. If you'd like to get a 2024 Tarot and Oracle forecast, it's now available on my website. You know, as always, I appreciate your kindness and support and watching my videos. I always appreciate a subscribe, a like, a comment. It means the world to me. So let me know in the comments if this resonates with you. Thank you very much, and I wish you the most amazing December.